The Cube at EMC World 2014 is brought to you by EMC. Redefine. VCE. Innovating the world's first converged infrastructure solution for private cloud computing. Brocade. Say goodbye to the status quo and hello to Brocade.
Okay, welcome back everyone. This is theCUBE, our flagship program. We go out to the events, extract the signal from the noise. We're live in Las Vegas for EMC World 2014. I'm John Furrier, the founder of SiliconANGLE. I'm my co-host Dave Vellante and CUBE analyst Stu Miniman, co-host here on theCUBE 2. For our wrap up for day one, for 3 days of wall-to-wall coverage. When I say wall-to-wall coverage, I mean there are two CUBEs here. There's actually two sets. 75 plus interviews going to be happening between today through Wednesday. Guys, exciting kickoff and first day, and a couple notable things. One, this marks our fifth season. EMC World 2010 in Boston was our first CUBE project. We actually went out and extracted the signal from the noise, Dave, our first time. And I think, Dave, it really highlights that, you know, one of the things that's happening is that theCUBE is generating an active community, and I think people like the content being engaged, and I just want to say it's been great working with you and the team and Stu, the new addition as a host on the team, Jeff Frick, and the entire team has just been really fun. A lot of people coming up saying, hey, theCUBE again, it's just really good, just want to say thank you. But as always, always a first at EMC World for us with the double CUBE action. But Joe Tucci dropping the hammer down with the big acquisition of DSSD, legend in Silicon Valley, Andy Bechtolsheim, of which Pat Gelsinger is kind of hinting, I'd known Andy for a long, long time, like it was in the works. So, besides all the other stuff going on, the normal flair and pomp and circumstance around EMC World, guys, Dave, DSSD is a huge deal. We heard a lot of people talking about software at the center of the value proposition. Dave, what is your take on that and
I think this is an area that has been a gap in EMC's portfolio. And this is, you know, I know Fusion IO past, you know, year or so, actually EMC World last year, Fusion IO replaced its founders and brought in Shane Robison. We had him actually on theCUBE remotely. But I always felt like, and even though, so the stock's been a little bumpy, I always felt like where Fusion IO played was at that server-side flash that's a memory extension. And that, to me, could be a super game-changing capability from an application development standpoint. All-flash arrays are great, hybrid arrays are great, putting flash into a traditional array, great, but when you start to talk about flash as a memory extension, not only eliminating the spinning disk, but eliminating all the overhead associated with the storage protocol, we're talking about more than one order, maybe more than two order, perhaps two to three orders of magnitude greater performance. I think that's what this DSSD acquisition was about, number one. Number two is, it appears that from looking at some of the things that have been written, Storage Mojo had something written on this, it appears that object is a focus. So they're taking object-based storage, which has always been known as slow, even though, you know, DDN has sort of attacked that problem a little bit, but now bringing that into transaction processing. So why is this exciting? This is exciting. We always talk about on theCUBE about big data, analytics, real time, and bringing transactional data and analytic data together so that machines can make decisions instead of humans making decisions before you lose the customer.
But the EMC question, Dave, I want to ask you is that EMC, you know, we were always speculating 2 years ago when they bought Extreme IO that, you know, Flash is a Hail Mary for EMC. Was it the right acquisition? We talked to the founders here today. Pat Gelsinger, now the CEO of VMware, was in charge of products at the time. And then Jeremy Burton took it over. Now he's the president of products. Damn good execution. They filled in those holes. They moved quickly. What's your take? Do you agree with that statement? And how far are we yet from seeing any meat on the bone here?
Well, I think it's still early. But having said that, EMC claims that it's number one in flash, and I believe that because, you know, what they don't say is they bundle flash into their deals. I mean, I'm sure, you know, Stu used to be at EMC. You know how they sell. And when they want to sell something, when they want to make it work, they will bundle it in, they'll incent the sales force to do it, and so I'm not surprised that they're number one. Now, the big question is, can these other companies, A, live up to their valuations? You know, I'm talking the Pures, Nimble's not really all flash array, but Violin's valuation is down. And B, you know, can they compete effectively with EMC? Now, Pure would say, well, we are competing effectively with EMC, we're growing at 100% per year, okay. So what's next for them? IPO, They get a lot of money in. Let's now see what happens in that fat middle of competition where EMC obviously kicks butt.
Yeah, Dave, you know, interesting comment on that. I mean, you know, one of the things people always used to say, EMC stands for the Execution Machine Company. I mean, they've got a huge sales force, they've got a huge channel, and when they point those guns,
there's another acronym there, Evil Machine Company, too, they go. Yeah, right? Yeah. But yes, Execution Machine, right?
Right, so, you know, when they came into the all-flash market last year, I mean, they did what? You know, $60, $65 million at the end of last year in the all-flash array, and they said that was the number one revenue for any all-flash array company because they've just got, you know, such, you know, presence in the marketplace, and they've got a channel and a sales force that can go out and, you know, sell anything. It's like Cisco's got that power on the marketplace. You know, very few companies can just go load up the field and, you know, go attack a market.
There's not a lot of examples of where they fumble. I mean, Envista was the one example that everybody always points to, but you look at even VPlex. Right? I mean, really, really interesting that now that thing you're seeing throughout the portfolio. So John, we're kind of geeking out on the portfolio here. Up-level a little bit. What's your take on EMC and EMC World?
I'd like to get it, Dave, into some of the geeky stuff about VCE, Tom Roloff's business. Some VCE was actually a good interview today. We want to get into why that's working. Obviously, the hybrid cloud that Pat Gelsinger. But to me, the big high-level thing that's happening here is the name of this conference is called Redefine. Now, that's not a coincidence that it's kind of similar to Amazon Web Services event called reInvent. Amazon is reinventing the cloud business and now moving into the enterprise. EMC is clearly putting up what I call that seawall, Dave. And they're using the word redefine because they're saying, why reinvent when you could redefine? Clearly, a subtle message around Amazon that they want to differentiate with the value that they have, one, two. Tucci actually came out on the keynote. Joe Tucci, the CEO, or chairman, if you will, of the Federation of EMC, talked about Amazon. He actually used the words Amazon Web Services in the same sentence as Google and Uber as a disruptive force. That means that EMC is now publicly recognizing Amazon Web Services as a viable competitor and putting the stake in the ground or that seawall so that that tsunami of Amazon does not brush up into the enterprise. So to me, that is the big thing right here that I'm seeing. And that to me is a really big deal, Dave. Amazon has put the mark on it. Now, Jeremy Burton's messaging is to actually include other words, like Elastic into the storage engine, another announcement. So Stu, that's Amazon-like.
Yeah, John, I had time to really dig in with some of the cloud providers, the cloud solution from EMC today, you know, hybrid cloud, service providers, you know, EMC's making sure that, you know, that they've got a pretty good cloud story, but, you know, it's the Federation story now. So VMware's got the vCloud hybrid service, Pivotal's got services they're offering, and EMC is trying to help, you know, build the solutions and put their infrastructure into a lot of cloud providers.
So big announcement on news front, guys, is the hybrid cloud innovations, okay? Elastic cloud storage appliance, not a service, and
that's
the Viper
essentially cloud in the box,
and Viper 2.0, and obviously the big mega announcement on the M&A deal. So, you know, clearly EMC is checking the boxes, big announcements. The pomp and circumstances is with Jeremy Burton, now president. Other notable fact is Jonathan Martin now is the new CMO. Really, I was impressed, and actually really happy for him because I really like him a lot. He walked on stage with the guitar, and I actually thought he was going to be air guitaring it. I'm like, okay, nice gimmick. He actually was playing, and then flipped the guitar to the guy, almost hit him in the face with the neck of the guitar. Trending on Twitter, great show for the new CMO, who's now out in the open, and so big changes at EMC, Dave.
Yeah, that was cool. He definitely pumped up the crowd. Here's the thing, let me go back to the cloud situation for a second. I mean, I know it gets kind of academic, but the point I keep hammering home is that online cloud services are starting to take on the shape of software marginal economics, meaning they go down, the marginal economics of software at volume go down to zero. It means every one new one you sell, it's pure profit. That's why Microsoft has, you know, 90% gross margins. So online services are starting to look like software. So that's huge. The key is volume. I don't yet see how EMC, the Federation, Cloud Foundry, Pivotal, VMware, I don't see how they get volume. I asked Pat Gelsinger that question. He said, well, we have a lot of partners, and okay, they do have a lot of partners, but that Stu, in your opinion, can that 1,000 points of light get the volume that an Amazon or a Google has and be able to get down that curve of online services economics?
Yeah, Dave, I'm with you. I'm very skeptical about some of those. When you look at EMC put forth that they're, you know, four-year TCO is cheaper than the big cloud guys. The question that you have is the price drops that happen from EMC and their partners versus the race to zero that we're seeing in the public cloud right now. And while today the four-year fully burdened cost and everything might be there, if I go 2 years from now, I'm going to say it's going to be a very different equation.
Well, I want to see that analysis. I want to see the assumptions. And
yeah, I totally agree.
So one of the things I want to talk about, Pat Gelsinger, you mentioned the cloud. We asked about Docker and the container trend, Stu, and he said, containers have been around, and if they want that containers, we'll add that on. Oh, by the way, the only one container that's been successful is VMs. So it's interesting to get his perspective. Again, you know how Pat can be parochial a little bit about that, but I think once it gets on his radar, obviously we saw all the rage of Docker at Red Hat Summit, so that's interesting. The other thing I asked him about was valuations, Dave, and he mentioned before we went on camera about Intel Cloudera, and he said that's a great move for Intel, it gets them out of the distribution business, but he thinks they paid way too much on the valuation side from a sizable investment. I thought that was pretty big.
Well, here's what he said. He said, I think we just saw the peak of valuations. Now, we'll see. You know, I've heard that before. I mean, if the market is really as big as we think it is, then maybe not. You know, maybe the best is yet to come.
I want to ask you guys about VCE, because we had Praveen on, and that was actually a very good interview. Had the most votes on CrowdChat today at crowdchat.net/EMCworld, Dave. We've been covering this, Stu, you have as well. VCE makes a good run. The naysayers, I mean, there's been naysayers from the beginning. Joint ventures don't work. Dave, we speculated on this at Cube many years ago. You know, that it's going to be, you know, either implosion or success. Vblock is validated. What's your take on this? How did they get here? What did they have to, why the market fit? Is it timing, execution? What's your take
on this? Stu and I have been consistent on this, maybe for different reasons, Stu, because you kind of came out of EMC and you saw that whole VC thing grow up. I just look at it from a business standpoint. First of all, it made evolutionary sense. I always felt like EMC had nothing to lose in this equation and everything to gain, essentially attacking the server market with VMware. And I always felt, despite everybody saying, oh, they're losing money like crazy, they're spending money like crazy, I said, I quantified it. They said, this is a $400 billion TAM, and it takes billions of dollars to go after that opportunity. They went for it, and I never had a problem with, you know, the accounting. Where, yeah, okay, fine, let VC lose the money and let the division, let Brian Gallagher take the revenue. Beautiful, I have no problem with that. Let VMware take it, let Cisco take it. No problem with that. The entity just made so much sense. Now they're at $1.8 billion run rate. I don't know how they account for it. I don't know, they've never said they're profitable, but it is good business. It's driving business, it's dragging along services. I guarantee this initiative, VC, is reigning green for EMC.
Yeah, Dave, you know, what still surprises me is I think the competition still underestimates VCE. I've never seen a company that, you know, did over $1 billion worth of revenue last year and is still, it's kind of quietly
growing at 50%.
It's growing at 50%. You know, they could be a $2 billion business within the next 12 months.
Oh, they will be.
You know, they should be. Oh. And the competition still kind of just, oh, well, Cisco and EMC are going to fight, or, you know, they're not there. Or they're not that, I'm like, they are raking in money. When the startups in the space are talking about having a $1 billion valuation, and VCE is bringing in billions of dollars.
Here's what's relevant about that. Name another, you know, let's say $2 billion plus company growing at 50%+ a year, Amazon. Oh, it's not a coincidence in my view that why is VCE doing well? It's because people internally are trying to replicate the cloud, the public cloud, and they don't want to go to the public cloud necessarily. They want to build their own cloud, and they don't want to do all the non-differentiated heavy lifting, so they're saying, let's put in a block of infrastructure. So John, that's my take on why VC.
Okay guys, great wrap up for day one. Again, day two tomorrow, we're going to have Jeremy Burton on, a bunch of folks from EMC and VMware, we're going to have Pivotal on, and a bunch more cube action, double cube, hashtag double cube.
Users, but John, we got the Vatican Library CIO coming on. I'm really excited for that one.
It's a great mix this year. We got the thought leadership, double barrel shotgun of thought leadership here on theCUBE. That's what's happening here. It's a wrap up from day one live in Las Vegas for EMC World. We'll be back tomorrow. Stay with us for more continuous coverage of EMC World. This is theCUBE in our fifth season, kicking off here at EMC World. We'll be right back tomorrow. Stay with us.